these things, finally. There's a lot of ultra in this episode. First the ultra stone for our partners. And now we also have the ultra hammer. Our party is becoming very, very strong. And other than the strength that we actually increase, we now also have more abilities to progress. The metal blocks now are prey. We can actually check out all of the rooms that were previously blocking us, including this one down here. This one is optional, not per se required in order to beat this place, but it is going to lead to a badge. I'm still going in here and pick up that badge. Going to be a piranha plant over here. Let's go and put our strongest party member. And let's do some damage. Ultra damage. Now that we have the ultra hammer, we can now of course also do more damage. 6 is now our standard attack. At least with the action command. Otherwise it's going to be 3 of course. And with Sushi being able to do 5 damage, our potential, our regular potential for doing damage has now increased to 11 per turn. And if we start doing fancy, like using tidal waves for instance, we can become a very dangerous force. Okay, got 6 of them. 6 damage to the piranha, 8 to the lava bubble. Awesome. Mario, finish this guy. I don't need stronger boots against the fire enemies, for that I already do more damage because of the ice power badge. Now, Mr. Piranha, this is going to hurt. Boom. So awesome. Mario is able to do 6 damage without using FP. Time for us to see what this room is all for. The badge is actually locked in a chest, so it remains a mystery until now. It is a Dizzy Stomp badge. If it works, the enemy Mario jumps on becomes dizzy. Another badge in our pocket. Time for us to leave again. And actually move towards the final block that we actually met in here. The continuation. Because that is indeed going to be there. Nothing more to pick up in here, so... returning right. I do really love the effects of the smoke you actually see here. Of course, because of being in a volcano, you do have these toxic damps hanging around. But I do really love how they were actually colored in. I think it's a cool coloring effect they actually created with that. Over the trampoline. Kolorado is also here, by the way. You were also stuck by the looks of it. My finely honed intuition tells me that great discoveries lie just beyond here. But there's this mysterious block in the way. Curses, what to do? What you need to do is actually look for a chest that actually contains a very strong hammer. Yes, excellent. Now, Mario, no time to hang about. Onward to glory. Let's go see what we can find here. Oh. It smells like treasure. Treasure, old boy. Make way. I'm going ahead. Bye? Sometimes you can actually also rush things a bit too quickly. And don't forget, the moment you see a beam of light, jump. Because that way we can actually land on a higher platform in the room below, containing the next super block. So this one we definitely don't want to skip. We're going to power up what? We already know she's a viable weapon. And now with her ability to do even more damage, she's going to be one nasty character to fight with when you're on the opponent's side. She'll be able to do 5 damage. And remember, that one's going to be defense piercing. Allow me to show you. 6 damage with Mario. Now, what's also able to do 5 damage? Unfortunately, not enough for these piranha plants, because they happen to have 12 HP. In the end, it does not matter. And they will still fall. Something I'm also almost going to do, by the way. I'm noticing I've dropped below 10 HP, so... things are not per se going too well. But now that we have more power, both on Mario and on our partners, we should be able to actually survive a bit better, hopefully. Star points are enough for a level up, by the way, so never mind the HP being low. We're going to level up our HP. After dropping so low in this place, I actually think we need that. Star piece in the panel over here. Also easily overlooked. A And that's all we can do in the lower room. So let's return upstairs. No, first we need to do one more battle against the spike top. Increasing my coins again. Should be increasing my star points, Merlee. However, like I explained earlier, this is also not per se bad. Should we turn up? Oh, speaking of up, aren't you going to get up? Don't mind me, Mario. Just investigating this floor a bit more closely. You go on ahead. Oh, my aching. Well, you're lucky to have a shell, sir. That probably broke your fall for quite a bit. Okay, did I get all of them? Yeah, looks like it. Where were we? Detour taken care of. Time for us to continue. Now we take the trolley all the way. We can move on to the next room. Oh, help! Time for us to go! Ooh. Man, that was scary. Indiana Jones traps are also a thing in here now. Let's go see more of these fire bars. Also a lava bubble. Hopefully the guy's not going to spot me. It is going to make jumping over this thing a bit trickier. If you are going to distract me, but it looks like you did not see me. First, I'm going to grab the coins, otherwise they are going to be gone. More coin increasing, Merlee. Man, you definitely want me to buy all of the badges by this point, it looks like. Ralph is going to be very happy with me when I'm done with this chapter. More coins. I want more coins. Mario has never been so greedy before. And we have not even reached New Super Mario Bros. 2 yet in the last place. Not even close to that game yet. That is going to put greed to a whole new level. Goodbye. So awesome, being able to do freaking 8 damage without sacrificing a single point of FP. Being able to do that really feels awesome. What? Finish this guy and we are done here. After the level up, these guys only give one more star point. Applies to both the lava bubbles and the spike tops. Partially overleveled in this part of the game, apparently. Again, successful, without taking a single point of damage. Looks like I know what I'm doing when it comes to jumping over fire bars. As if I've been playing more Mario in my life. But luckily we know better. Next room. Oh, more of these rolling thwomps. First we're going to... Oh! Get rid of the enemies, but there's a bit too many of them. Caught me by surprise. 4 enemies, that feels like a star storm. It at least feels like something I don't feel like doing normally. Luckily also a defense piercing move, so even this will work against spike tops. 7 damage, so one attack from what is going to be enough. Leaving only one more piranha plant. Going to try to poison me, unsuccessfully by the way. And goodbye. Perfect. More coins for Mario. And more piranha plants. Yeah, I'm not going to say I'm surprised anymore. You could actually make another remark about once again a coins increasing. It actually also made Merlee's spell run out. Perhaps for the better, I was just getting extra coins and no extra star points. Now, let's go over here. Mario! Wait! Wait one moment! Oh, you're back again. According to the information I've gathered, the hidden treasure should be right around here. But I need to go a little farther. Yeah, but looking at this wall, there is no little farther. However, of course, that is something we can resolve. This block over here is not here for nothing. We can actually use it in order to move it all the way to the left. Yeah, you need to be a bit patient for this. This is going to take a while. At least we have the cool smoke effects to look at. But then we actually arrive. We're able to break these blocks. And I think you can guess what is going to happen. Breaking this final block will actually make this thwomp roll. Make sure to not be in his path. Move aside. Something Kolorado is stupid enough not to do. Oh, and he's once again in a lot of pain. And for some reason, we are not feeling sorry for him, aren't we? Barely nicked me. Oh boy. Oh, my poor shell. Ow. Yeah, his shell's really getting a number. I'm actually surprised it is still in one piece after all the beating it has been getting. Oh, he's already back up again. Kolorado, what are we going to do with you? Close. So very close. My treasure hunting senses are going simply mad right now. My intuition tells me it is over here. The room to the right, huh? My treasure sensor is actually telling me there's a star piece over here. My treasure sensor is called my notes, by the way. It's also an in-game sensor, I know, but after doing my homework beforehand, I actually don't need that. Let's go take a look at Colorado's treasure sensor, shall we? The block over here will actually contain a super shroom. Might actually be handy to use for healing, but there's also a healing block near here, so I don't really see the point. The same will apply to your FP. There's maple syrup here. I've got plenty of those already, so let's go toss it. Oh, huh? There seems to be nothing. Alas, even my finely honed intuition can be wrong on occasion. I shall not give up. Let's head back the other way. Perhaps the treasure is a bit deeper down in the volcano. Yeah, that has got to be. We did see a staircase leading down near the healing block over here. I guess that is where we need to go. Also a safe block. A healing block, a safe block. This kind of promising something, isn't it? Time for us to switch to our partner that's strong against fire. And not for nothing. Mario still approaching. Identified as searching for Star Spirit. Code Red reports to boss. Alert! Alert! I love how piranha plants are actually being put down as robots in this game. However, the master of the piranha plants, and that is what we need to face. The Star Spirit is guarded right over here. Time for us to face the next chapter boss. The dangerous lava piranha.
Black yak 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 yak. You made it, Mario. You guys, bad guys. Bad guys come to steal Star Spirit. Bad guys who come to steal Star Spirits get hurt. We don't let it happen. No. We trap Star Spirit. We get this volcano. Volcano is ours. Good deal. We make things hot for you. We beat you, Mario.
Well, similar to the Shy Guys, apparently this is also a location that was promised to these guys by Bowser. To keep them loyal. But now it is time for us to actually kick them out. Literally kicking them out. Because of it being an elevated enemy, the hammer is unfortunately useless to us. We still need to take him on with our normal jump. Immediately missing the action command. Good start. Tempting to use an AoE on these guys already, but let's go do a normal attack first. And now, his attack. Both of his side tentacles will actually function as loose enemies, and therefore will also have an attack. In this case, a fast fireball. And the regular boss itself will also attack. So, as long as these guys are intact, they will actually attack three times during one turn. That will make these guys pretty dangerous. And I'm also having a lot of trouble with my action command, it looks like. Not sure what is happening, but apparently it is not working out for me. Time for an AoE. I need to take out these other tentacles. Otherwise this match is going to be very annoying. And I'm probably not going to be able to survive. Okay, they have more than 5 HP. So you need 2 attacks in order to take them out. Or perhaps 1 if they have 6 HP, but I was not able to do the action command optimally. So it only did 5 damage. Also need to work on the action command for jumping on this guy. Which once again does not work. Come on. Alright, let's do another tidal wave. I'm not going to be using FP on Mario then, if this is actually giving me so much trouble. Need all of my FP points for sushi. Yeah, there they go. They're not going to disappear from the map, obviously. They will actually return after a couple of turns. But at least now the Lava Piranha can actually only attack me once, so... Oh, come on, can I get at least one jump attack in that actually works? Also missing the action commands for the defense now. let's go try again. Oh, there we go. Apparently that is difficult. And no, still not. Waiting for a certain moment, of course. Again? No, it was too good to be true. But at least we have reached the end of phase 1 by the looks of it. The end of the fight. You receive star points, however, only half the star points, as you can see, only 15. And that is because it is of course not that easy. He will return. But now, with a fire element. It is now a fire enemy. So now Sushi is actually happy. But I am too, because I've still got ice power. So even if I miss the action command, I will still do 4 damage. And Tidal Wave is now also going to do more damage. That is of course a water attack. Now I will take out the tentacles in one hit, no matter what. 7 damage. Mario, you shan't fight alone. Kolorado, to the rescue! Hi-ya! Oh, of course. Ow, 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 hot! Oh, it burns, really? so sorry, old chap, but that is all I can do at the moment. Good luck with all of this. Was that really necessary, Kolorado? But okay, let's go continue the fight. These guys are now rendered useless, as you can see, just like my jump attack, that is also useless. But as long as these guys are stunned, we've got an easy time. They will reactivate both of the side tentacles and the Lava Piranha itself. However, of course, still as a fire element. Let's go heal ourselves a bit of FP. So Sushi can take care of business. Actually dousing these flames. Thank you, L-Star. 10 FP, enough for another tidal wave. The C down button is always very tricky, I feel. This is enough. Boss is yet again stunned. Not going to be able to attack me at all. Let's go sacrifice the final bits of my FP with a power jump. Still not getting that action command. It's really difficult to get, apparently. I did get it once, but not afterward. Now the boss should be around defeated by now. No, I'm not doing optimally when it comes to my damaging. It should be around done. So, one more tidal wave. And I think we've got this in the bag. Mario's jump is proven tricky on this guy. But luckily, we've got a partner whose attack is working for us. Even though this one was not really that great. But still 6 damage. Enough for another stun. Time for Mario to finish this with 2. Yeah, 2 damage. But it was enough for the final bit of damage this guy was not able to take. And the boss of chapter 5 falls, giving us another 30 star points.